Hello mommies and daddies, welcome to Shishu World. Today we are going to make a multigrain Cerelac powder which can be given to babies over 8 months as well as toddlers and older children as porridge. We've also shared this recipe in Hindi and you can click the link to view it in Hindi. To subscribe to our channel, hit the subscribe button and do not forget to hit the bell icon to get all our videos. So let us look at all the ingredients at first. So as you can see, I have divided the ingredients into three different rows. The first row or the top row is that of cereals, which are the energy giving ingredients. So here we have taken three kinds of cereals. The first one is rice. It is half cup of rice. Second is ragi. This also is half cup. Ragi is also known as nachni in some places. And the third one is jaw ka dalia or barley dalia. If you do not have barley dalia, you can also use wheat ka dalia, which is broken wheat. Now the second row is the protein ingredients or the lentils. So we have taken different kinds of lentils here. The first one is dhuli moong ki dal or the regular moong dal. This is quarter cup. We have also taken urad dal. This is 1/8 of a cup, that is half that of the moong dal. We have taken toor dal or pigeon peas, masoor ki dal, and then whole green gram as well, which is the whole moong dal. They are, other than urad dal, everything is 1/4 cup. I have taken some nuts, which are, again, they give good fats and also are rich in proteins. So I have taken cashew and almonds and peanuts, and the quantity is about 1/4 cup each. And I have cumin seeds here. So we have 1/4 cup of peanuts and 1/4 cup combined of cashew and almonds. First thing that we have to do is we have to wash all the ingredients to make sure that there are no impurities in it. So I've washed it in running water, all the cereals together, because the quantity is quite less. If you are making it in large quantity, you can also wash it separately. Now once we have washed it and drained all the water, then I've spread it on the kitchen towel and then I'll dry it under the fan, or if you have good sun, you can also dry it in the sun for some time. Then the same process I'll repeat with the pulses. Add all the pulses and then wash them in running water. Make sure that there is no dust, nothing in it. And then we will dry it again in a kitchen towel or a cotton cloth. You can dry it under the fan for some time. And after that, we will roast it to make sure that there is no water at all before grinding. So mix it all. Now here we have washed all the lentils nicely and filtered out all the water. We've drained the water. And now we will dry it off on a kitchen towel. You can also wash and dry the nuts, but if they are clean, there is no need. So now the next process is to dry it off completely by roasting. So once we have dried the cereals under the fan, now I have taken them in a pan and I'm going to dry roast it completely to remove all the moisture that was there and also to partially cook it before grinding it. We have to do this process on medium heat. Make sure that it is not very high, medium to low heat, and keep stirring it so that all the moisture gets evaporated and it becomes nice, light and crunchy. So that when you put it in your mouth, you should be able to eat it just like that. This will take a few minutes. Keep stirring it. Now, as you can see, there's still quite a lot of moisture, but after a few minutes, you will see that it will become nice and dry. As you can see, now all the moisture has evaporated and the grains are looking very light and crunchy. So just a
few seconds more, and when you are happy, you have to take it aside and keep it in a plate to cool down. All these cereals and pulses after roasting must be cooled down completely before you can grind it. So once you think they are ready, like I'm tasting it here, they look perfect. So I'm taking it out on a plate and I'll spread it out and allow them to cool down completely. Now in the same pan, I will add the washed lentils. Now if you are making it in a large quantity, you can do this process separately. Like you can roast the green grams first because it might take a slightly longer time, and the other dals separately. But because the quantity is quite less, I'm doing the process all at the same time. And here, as we can see, they have completely dried. They are looking nicely roasted. The color is also changing. And it's very important that you keep stirring this mixture. Otherwise, you will see that it will start burning from the bottom. So those have been roasted. Now I have added the nuts. So first we've added the cashew and the almonds, and after about a minute I've added the peanuts. We'll nicely roast them. You can see it's looking nicely roasted, and at the end we'll add the cumin seeds. Cumin seeds will roast for barely a minute and it will be ready. Now cumin seeds not only gives a nice taste to it, but also improves the digestibility. So when you give this to your baby, it will be good for digestion. So now everything has been cooled down. The next process is to grind all of these. So the cereals are ready, then pour the lentils. All of them will go in the same mixer jar. And then the nuts and the cumin seeds. And then we have to grind it into a fine powder. I'm also adding some flaxseed powder here. This is optional, but I have it ready and it is very good. So I've added it. But if you do not have it on hand, you may just roast flaxseed and add it, or you may skip it also. Now here, as you can see, I have ground it nicely. So we'll take it out, and if there are any lumps, we'll check that, and we can filter it out with the help of a sieve to make sure that if there are any bigger pieces, we can again grind it and make sure that we get a nice fine powder. This powder can be stored in an airtight container, and you can keep it up to 3 to 4 months inside the fridge and even outside for over a month. And then you can just use it as per your need whenever you want to make this cereal for your baby. So we'll have a look at what the process is, how we can do it. So first, what we have done is we've taken about half a cup of water, and we'll just mix this in cold water. We've taken 1 spoon, mix it in cold water so that there are no lumps. And after you've mixed it well, that is when we'll start the heat. So now we'll start cooking it, and just keep stirring it so that there are no lumps. How we cook any other porridge and all, the same way. So now there is a boil in the water. We'll stir it. Added a tiny piece of jaggery, and it looks very well cooked, barely 3 to 4 minutes, and it will be ready. If you feel that it needs little more cooking, add a little more water and then cook it a little more. But this looks okay. So I've turned off the heat now, and at this point I'm adding a few drops of ghee. Ghee is very good for children, and you can easily give ghee to babies who are 7 to 8 months. Few drops, don't give a lot, but a few drops of ghee you can easily add. Add the milk or the formula milk, whatever you want to add to this.
and mix everything well. And the multigrain cereal is ready for your baby. You can give this as a lunch, dinner, breakfast, whichever time. It is very nutritious and helps in weight gain as well. I do hope you like this video, and if you did, don't forget to hit the like button and to subscribe to the channel. We'll see you again very, very soon. Thank you so much for watching. Bye-bye.